Doctor, she said. Yeah, I thought I'd start off by not actually speaking because I sound like this. And when I was a teenager and, you know, all that, you know, puberty, voice breaking, my voice never really noticeably broke. It just went from squeaky to slightly less squeaky. And an example of this is, I've written down some of the football results from the weekend. I'm shaking, I'm nervous, yeah. Yeah, I wrote some of the football results from the weekend down on this train ticket here. like you do, you know, train journey, bored, smartphone, had about the last 5% of battery left, you've got to do something. Everton 0, Liverpool 0, Aston Villa 2, Wigan 0, Manchester United 2, Norwich 0, Adult 1, Child 0. Hold on. Hello? Yeah, hold on a second.
It's for you.
She's eating. Now, you're probably like me, you probably wander around the supermarket and think, if all these things in the supermarket had their own personalities and could talk, what would they say? And, you know, like the egg, it would be real cocky little gobshite. It'd be like, yeah, look at me, top of the fucking food chain. I can make anything. You can make anything with me. You can make quiche, cake, omelette, what they call pancakes, Yorkshire puddings, and they're from the same recipe. Give it up. You can fry me, hard boil me, poach me, scramble me, add cheese, that's another dish, thanks to the Welsh. You know, it'd be really up itself. You know, you've got sliced bread. I did have an egg, but it on somewhere between my house and Reading Station, it self-destructed. And sliced bread, you know, it'd be, well, everyone knows I'm the best thing since the wheel, you know. I mean, they've all seen the scattergraph. But to be honest, I just want to get through life, make friends, enjoy life. I don't go on about it, you know. But then, the coconut. I mean, that's, to be honest, it's not got much self-confidence. It's, you know, it's like, well, you know, you get bounty bars, you get coconut ice, but there's probably more people that don't particularly like me than do. And I've got a horrible, rough, hairy exterior, I've got milk, no fucking likes. And I'm a top 5 food allergen in India, thank you, Wikipedia. So I'll just, you know, keep myself to myself, not expect much out of life, not really talk to many people. And to sum it up, egg, arrogant, sliced bread, modest, coconut, shy. I'll tell you what, supermarkets, which is what this is largely about, I love getting bargains in the supermarket. You get sucked in, you get too many to buy two for whatever, and end up spending shitloads, which I do. I got brilliant bargain the other week. I bought a packet of grapes that had been heavily reduced. Now, I don't normally buy food secondhand. It's a bit weird, it's not sort of what you do. But the other day, all this lot, After Eights, Matchmakers, I can't be asked, but there's Mentos, Polos, and Tic Tacs. I thought, well, they are in outstandingly good condition. Maltesers, that could have been a soap opera set in Malta. these things, I can't understand a word they're saying. Most spoken language in the world, apparently, but. I haven't got any jokes about, but bananas. Hummus. Sometimes I eat some of that, and after it, I give out awards to dead people. a few little notes. Tell you what, do you think the first ever person to be found with a slightly below average body temperature was a bloke called Luke?